afternoon. On behalf of the members and staff, we welcome you to Muncie Memorial United Methodist Church for this concert by Marilyn Kaiser. Before I introduce Dr. Kaiser, I'd like to just make a couple of remarks and express appreciation to a few very important people. For centuries, the church organist has been the primary leader and sustainer of congregational song in the life of the church. Churches have had song leaders and cantors and directors and other such people, but most of us know that the person responsible for the sustaining and encouraging of congregational song in the life of the church is the church organist. We have been fortunate here at Muncie Church, and this is kind of, in a sense, kind of a celebration of that, that for really almost 60 years, 59 as it turns out, that role in this church has been in the capable of the hands of essentially three people. The role and leadership of congregational song at the organist at Muncie has been filled by Jane LaPella since 1964 through 2014. And David Runner served us as the interim during 2014, and since that time, Matthew Bricky has served as our organist and music associate and directs our children's choir ministry. We have been grateful for this long-term and sustaining presence. There have been many other people who have been substitutes and have guests and different along the way, but the three of them are the ones who have been the prime leaders of all that we have done in terms of our work together. And I am grateful, and I know that the church is grateful too. The organ in this sanctuary was originally built in 1955 and was a gift to the church by the Massengill family. In 1986, it was rebuilt by the R.A. Colby Company. And then again in 2005, it was rebuilt and expanded with a new console, also by the Colby Company. The Colby family and their employees have given loving attention and care to this instrument for many years. And we are deeply grateful for all that they do. And Brad Colby is with us today, and we say thank you to Brad and to the entire Colby organization for all that they have done to keep and maintain this organ over the years. Marilyn Kaiser, our artist for today, though a teacher and concert performer and world-renowned artist, is also a church musician. She has said that one of her great loves is the leading of congregational song. Later, we're going to get to sing a hymn together. Dr. Kaiser's bio is on the back of the program. I'm not going to read it to you. You can read that and see there's, and you could, if you look it up online, it's three times that long. You know, you have to cut somewhere to figure out how they're going to get it in. I first heard her play in 1979 at a United Methodist Musicians Convocation in Albion, Michigan. It was a transformational experience for me. Not only her artistry and the elegance in the way that she played, but also in the way that her dangling earrings could keep perfect rhythm with her playing. I did not know that for all of my college years at Western Carolina in Cullowhee, North Carolina, that she was just up the road in Asheville playing at All Souls Parish. I wish I'd known. We are deeply grateful for her presence here today in this concert, and I also need to say another word of appreciation to one of her successors at the now Cathedral of All Souls, Kyle Ritter, who made the initial contact for her presence here. And in the interest of full disclosure, Kyle is my brother-in-law and is also perhaps the most overqualified page turner ever for today's concert. And so without any other delay, please welcome Marilyn Kaiser.
Thank you. two pieces are by J.S. Bach. There are transcriptions from cantata movements, and the first one is a setting of a melody that's in many of our hymnals, if thou but trusted God and to guide thee. And then the second one was written for a municipal election in Leipzig in 1731. It was written for a choir. Both of these pieces were choral pieces and adapted by two other organists, Harvey Grace and Marcel Dupre. But I hope you enjoy them.
Thank you.
16 organ concertos, and they were performed at the intermission of his oratorios. He'd play the accompaniment, Judas Maccabeus, and all these wonderful oratorios. They have been transcribed by a number of different people for organ solo, and I'm going to play two movements of the first concerto in G major.
Thank you.
next piece is by an English composer, Herbert Howells. I met Howells at a conference in England in the 1960s, late 1960s, and he talked about the horror of the Second World War when he was living in London, and he and his wife and children moved out of London. And then his son, Michael, died during that period of time. And so you can feel in a lot of his choral music and some of his organ music the incredible anguish, and yet at the end, this incredible peace and serenity. It's a beautiful piece. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
two pieces, sorry, pardon me, are by Dan Locklear. Dan is a composer at Wake Forest University. Winston lives in Winston-Salem, a longtime friend. And he wrote the first piece in memory, HHL, in memory of his mother, whose initials were HHL. What is the date on that, Kyle? I can't remember. Does it say?
2014.
And then also I'll be playing the Phoenix Processional, which shows off the big tuba on this organ. Say, his mother taught first grade Sunday school, and her favorite hymn to teach the children was "Jesus Loves Me," and so near the end of the piece, you'll hear a quote on the handbells of that tune.
Thank you.
was so much fun. When my father first heard me play that, he said, "What is that? The pedal glissando." He had never heard that before. You have to start up with your foot on the flat. You can't have your foot sideways, even a little bit. It has to be absolutely flat, in case you decide to play a pedal glissando ever. The next two pieces are by Americans. Sorry, Mark Jones was a student of mine in Asheville and lived in Miami and died of cancer several years ago. A very beautiful setting. He asked me many years ago what my favorite hymn was, or one of my favorite hymns, and I said the tune, Song One of Orlando Gibbons. And so he wrote this piece. And then a set of variations on Austria, Glorious Things of the Year Spoken. And we're going to sing the hymn before I play that. It's hymn 617. So I will introduce it, and then if you'd like to stand first. I understand from Doug that you're used to singing verses 1 and 4 in unison and the middle verses in parts. So if you'd like to do that, and then I'll play these wonderful variations by John Mills Payne. The first, is it 617?
731.
731. 731. Close. 731. Oh gosh, I'm tired. John Knowles Payne was the first professor of music in America at Harvard University, and these variations are wonderful. Thank you. pieces are by Louis Vierne, who was organist at Notre Dame Cathedral from 1900 until 1937. I hope you enjoy them.